Morning class. Today we are going to study about use of prepositions with special uses. Okay, how can we use for other purpose also, or where other in only not only with place, time, and movement? How can we use prepositions in other way? Okay, like if I want to say about of, uses of. I ate a plate of rice and a quarter of milk. I need 3 pieces of paper. Again, there are several ways of cooking upma. So how can you use of? How are you using of here? I'll tell you. Wait a minute. Okay. Then again, there is one more thing. This for which I'm having problem in my screen. Why it is coming? Just wait a minute. Yes, wait. Okay, so again I'll start. Good morning everyone. Today we will study prepositions with special uses. Now, how can you use of? When you want to use of, you can use it like your example is given. I need 3 pieces of paper. So you can use from the source, from where it is coming. Okay, your source. Like if I say chairs are made of wood. So what is the source of chair? How it is made? It is made of wood. Like if I say he died of hunger. So when you are using for illness, or like he died of malaria. So when you want to use for illness, you can also use of. Another way, when you want to like this is the table of the chair, when you want to show the relation. Okay, this is the leg of the table. Sorry, this is the leg of the table. It means you are showing the relation of the leg with the table. Now again, how can you use for? When you want to use for, you can use for special purpose, or for you want to work for somebody. Like if I say he has brought a book for me, it means he is working for somebody. Or you can say if there is a special purpose, like I had like a new computer for Christmas. Or is there place for me on this seat? Now, what is the use of with? When you want to use with, how can you use it? It can be used when you are using any tool. For example, he pounds nail with a hammer. You want to say about resources. If you want to say about definite and stable sense. What is definite and stable sense? Like if I say we hear with our ears. So this is your definite and stable sense. When you depart. When you depart, then also you can use with. Like we do not like to part with our friends. When you want to be together. So how can you say come with your friends? So this is the way you can use with. Now, prepositions can be used with adjectives and verbs. What are adjectives? Describing words. And what are verbs? Action words. Now, how can we use them? Like, Dad was angry with us. So angry is what? It's an adjective. John is very good at drawing. Again, good is what? Adjective. So this way you can use with adjectives. Now, how can you use with verbs? Example, I am looking for my pencil. Have you seen it? So looking is what? It is a verb. Can you think of another word for pleased? So again, think is what? It's again verb. I agree with you. So this way also we can use prepositions with some verbs. Now, we can also use prepositions with nouns or noun phrases. Noun, you can see, like if I say, what's the answer to this question? Is there a reason for delay? Or you can also use for noun phrase. Noun phrase is incomplete set of words which has noun in it. So should I'll give you another example. How can you use prepositions with noun? My sister is sitting on the chair. So on is your preposition and the chair is your noun. If I say many children travel by the metro every day. The metro every day is a noun phrase because it is complete set of word. But metro is a noun here. Metro train we are talking about. So during by is what? Your preposition and metro every day. This is a noun phrase. So this way you can use preposition with adjectives. You can use with verbs. You can use with noun or noun phrase. Now, some other uses of prepositions. When you want to use by, how can you use? By is also used to tell the time. If I want to say know the time, how will you ask your friend or how will you ask your mother? You can ask, what is the time by your watch? You will not say, what is the time in your watch? You will say, what is the time by your watch? Then, if you want to show the near position of a thing or a person, come and sit by me. Again, if you want to use it as a medium, I shall go to Ajmer by bus. Now, another word which is given in your exercise, that's why I have taken those words only so that it is clear to you all, right? Now see, when you are looking at page number 50, another use of beside and besides is given. So what is the basic difference between beside and besides? When we are talking about beside, it means close to or next to. As given in the example, don't walk beside me. Or you can say, don't walk next to me. Or don't walk close to me. But when I say besides, it means in addition to, means something is added there. I have three other hats besides this. It means already I am having one and now I am having three more in addition. So this way you can use beside and besides. Now, when we talk about between, or we talk about among. So between is to indicate time period between two time points. Or you can use with two separate and distinct things or persons. Like if I want to say, I can stay with you between 5 p.m. and 6 p.m. It means I am telling the time between 5 and 6. Then there is a tree between two houses. So I am telling the position or the place of the tree which is between two houses. When you are talking about among, it is more than two. It is about a group. Okay. Now, I'm just sharing a little bit of my screen here. And here we can just study what are the different uses. Like if you are showing time, how can you use at? When you want to say exact time. If I say, what is the time by your watch? You can, when you are saying the exact time, so you can use at, like I will go to my friend's house at 3 p.m. It means this is the definite time. When you want to tell the time for meal times, like dinner, lunch, breakfast, that time also we use at dinner, at lunch, at the breakfast, or and so on. If you want to say about age, at age 21. Now, when you want to use by to show time, how will you say? A limit in time, by sundown, If you want to say in the sense at the latest, you will say by the due date. Okay. Now, in, how can you use in for showing time? You can use for seasons, in the summer, for months, in November, for years, in 1992, 94, 96, so on, for durations. In the same year, COVID-19 will end in the same year. Okay, this year only it will end. Or you can say after a certain period of time, or you can say in an hour. I will complete my work in an hour. Now, what is the use of on? This we have already studied, but I'm just going through it. Excuse me. When you want to speak about days of the week, like I will complete my work on Wednesday, or you want to say about the parts of the day where the day is named, like he will come on Friday night, I will go there on Thursday morning. So when you want to say about the part of the day, you use on. Again, when you want to say something about dates, then we always say on December 4th. We will have our sports day on December 4th. I will take a leave on December 5th. So whenever you are saying something about date, you will use on. Ago. Ago is used for a certain time in the past. 2 years ago, I visited my nanny's house. 2 years ago, I went to see the museum. Okay. After. After is used a point in time that follows another point, like I will study after the game. Before, a time, point in time that precedes another point, like before leaving, I will complete my assignment. Before leaving, I will clean my table. Before leaving, I will just clean my cupboard. So this is the way how you can use before. Now during, something that happened or will happen in a specific period, like during the night, during the war, this way, whatever is happening in that period, that time we will use during. For is used over a certain period in the, like, for 2 years. I have been waiting for 2 years. So when you want to use for, you will use it over a certain period of time. Now, another, past. It is telling the time. 10 past 6. Now, since. Since is used from a certain period of time. Since 1980. Since the accident. Since 1980, my grandfather has been writing poems. Okay, throughout. Something that will happen in a specific period of time. Like throughout the year, I have been trying to improve my writing. Throughout the year, we are speaking English. We are communicating in English. Now, two, when you are telling time, 10 to 6, whenever somebody asks time, how do you say? What is the time? It's 10 to 6, means 10 minutes are left to 6. When you want to say from an earlier time to the later one, 1 p.m. to 3 p.m., I study from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. Until, up to a certain point in time, until the end. Up from an earlier point to the later point. Now, okay, so these are the basic some prepositions which are telling how can we use. Now, when you want to show place, again you can use at, by, and in. When you want to show the location, you want to show the direction, you want to show the events, you can use like at the airport, at home, turning at the intersection, throwing the snowball at my friend. When you want to use by, you can use it close to, by the school. Okay. along of, by the window. When you want to use in, it means it is used in within an enclosed space, like in the garage, in the room. When you want to show like any geographic location, like in Texas. When you want to show anything in a printed medium, like in a book, in a magazine, you will say this picture is in a book, this picture is in a magazine. Now on you can use for a certain side. Keep this book on the left. Okay, when you want to use for river or lake, or you can use on for a flat surface. So London lies on the Thames. When you want to use for a floor in a house, on the floor, on a bus, on the air, on TV. We never say in TV. I saw this news in TV. I saw this news on TV. Okay. Again, when you want to use around, about, you means it is around or outside of, it means about town. Example is about town. Again, when it is related, I am talking about my father's business. It means something you are talking which is related to your father. At is at, but not exactly. About 5 feet tall. You don't know the exact, but you are just talking about exact on. Okay. Above. Above means suspended higher than something else. Something which is above anything else, which is covered. Like above the door. Then you can use superior to. She is above me in rank. After means you are just chasing after the robber, running after. Or you can say a point further from earlier point. The corner after the big house. Against means when you are using it as opposing, like against the wall, or when you are leaning on, bending on something, against the door. Along means when you are along the line, tracing the length. Okay, like along the railway or along the river bank. You are walking along the river bank. Like river bank is also there and you are walking along that. Among means in the company of. Right now when I explained you between and among. So among means in the company or in a crowd or at end of a long list. Among other three other things. Among the friend. Among the masses. This way you can use among. Around means when you are showing the location of something. Drive along the block, drive along the mall, or you are explaining a period of time. Like I will visit your house around 3 p.m. Now what is the difference between round and around? When you are speaking about round, it means it is denoting a circular shape. It is telling about a movement of circular shape, anything moving in circle. When you are saying about around, it is telling about the location or where it is located or anything which is located on every side. So drive along the block. Block means something is located and you are driving along that side. Now before means it is in front, in the front in terms of space. In before the emperor, before God, now behind, it means at the back, below means underneath something, from, in the sense of from, where from where you have done this work or from where you have brought. So like a flower from the garden. Now see, when we speak about in and into, which is also given on page number 50 in your course, how will you differentiate between in and into? So when we are talking about mean in, it means it's an enclosed space. Okay, but when we talk about into, it is the movement to the top of something. It is a movement of entering a room or a building or something from one area to another area. Like if I say, go into the kitchen. It means you were in the living area or you were in the bedroom and now you are entering the next area, that is your kitchen part. So when you are entering from one area to another area, you will say into. But when you want to say in. It means, for example, if I say the boys played in the park. So park is an enclosed area. It has a boundary. It has a surrounding all over. So at that place you are going to use in, and into you are going to use when you are entering from one place to another place. Now onto, it is again movement on the top of something. Over, again you can use when you are covered by something else. Like put a jacket over your shoulder. When you want to say more than, over 16 years of age. When you are getting to the other side, like walk over the bridge. When you are overcoming an obstacle, climb over the wall. Next, through. Through I told you yesterday also. It's like when you are moving from one end to the another end, then it is said as drive through the tunnel. Okay. Now, towards, moving in the direction of something. Now, about. How can you use about? You can use about for topics. Today we are talking about prepositions. Meaning what about? Like now, at can be used for age. Like she learned Russian at the age of 45. By, who made it? This book is by Mark Twain. When there is a rise or fall of something, then we use prices have risen by 10%. When you are traveling, I travel by car, I travel by bus. From, whenever you are saying who gave it, you say a present from my friend, a gift from my mother. In again used when you are entering a car or a taxi, get in the car. When you are using off, how can you use? A page of the book. What or who did it belong to? The pages of the book. So means the pages belonging to the book. Or you can use off when you want to show something. The picture of a place. Again, off, OFF off. When you are leaving a public transport or a vehicle, get off the train, get off the bus. On, when you are walking or riding on horseback, or you are entering a public transport vehicle, like get on the bus or walk on a foot or on horseback. Out of, get out of the taxi, get out of the car when you are leaving a taxi or a car. So this much was your revision.